This is a demo on voltage divider circuit. Here in this circuit, a series of 500 ohms and 1 kilo ohms and 2 kilo ohms are connected in series. Now, our voltage divider circuit would consist of 1 kilo ohm and 2 kilo ohm for the output voltage, and the 500 ohm is the leader resistor. Now observe how the voltage would be divided in this R2 and R3. So now the 10 volts is supplied into the circuit, and as we can see, the voltage B here at the PR2 measures 8.57 volts, and this voltage measures with reference to the ground here, so meaning it measures the voltage from this point to the ground, and this is the voltage across R2 and R3. Now, this voltage PR3 measures 5.71, which is the voltage across the R3. So, this voltmeter measures with respect to the ground. We have a common ground, a single ground, and this voltmeters measures the voltages with respect to this ground. So, we did not connect anymore the negative terminal or the negative reference of the voltmeter, since we are measuring the voltage across each of these resistors respect to the common ground. Now, if we are going to add, as you can see, voltage across the PR2 is higher than the voltage across PR3. This is because this voltage is proportional to the resistance, to the value of the resistance. So since PR2 measures the voltage across R2 and R3, so it has a higher voltage output. So if we are going to connect a load across this higher voltage output, and let's see what would happen if we put across a resistor across the higher output voltage. Set the resistance to say 1 kilo ohm. So the voltage here is 8.57, that is without load. Now we have connected here a 1 kilo ohm resistor across the higher voltage, that is the voltage across R2 and R3. Let's close the switch S3. And the load now is consuming power, and the voltage on PR2 voltmeter found to be 6 volts, so it drops. The voltage drops to 6 from 8.57. But if we connect the load across a lower output voltage, so the voltage output at R3 is 5.7. Let us close the switch. It drops to 3.07. What if we further decrease the resistance? What would happen with the voltage output at these terminals? So you would study how the circuit would behave as the output terminals of a voltage divider is loaded. In the run-through, instead of a fixed resistor, we shall use a potentiometer or as a voltage divider. Here our bleeder resistor is 1 kilo ohm, and the maximum total resistance or 100% resistance for the potentiometer is 2 kilo ohm. So if we close the switch, so we have here, this is set to 50%. This is 1 kilo ohm. There is a bleeder of 1 kilo ohm, so the voltage is divided since the bleeder and the voltage at the potentiometer are equal. So let us adjust this to the higher value, say 85%. So as this resistance is increased, the voltage increases. Now let us across this, this is our output voltage, which is 6.44. If we connect a resistance across this terminal, what would happen? So we expect a drop. So the voltage without load switch is yet open. So the voltage at the terminals, load terminals, is 6.4412 volts. So if we close the switch, the voltage drops to 4.5 volts. This is at a load resistance of 1 kilo ohm. So what if we further decrease the resistance? What would happen with the voltage across the terminal? So you will study how the voltage output is affected by the value of the resistance of the load.